Everybody, this is Nick. Today we're just going to have some fun in PowerPoint with Morph and a photo and some text. This is my very, very sweet cat named Ruth, and we're just going to go ahead and make this really stunning effect in PowerPoint. Now, this is just for fun, but I bet you can think of some ways that you might want to use this technique in your work. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm going to do on my blank slide is we're going to turn the background of the slide to a different color. So I'm going to format the background color, and let's just choose this sort of deep purple there. I'm going to insert a photo from stock photos, from pictures here, stock images, and I'm just going to go ahead and type purple abstract. And you get a bunch of options. You could choose any of them. I think I went down here and I really like this sort of like raining down laser. Now the thing is, I'm going to go ahead and use my BrightSlide app right here. This is the free BrightSlide add-in. I'm going to go ahead and click on match size, and that crops the photo to match the entire size, the entire height and width of the slide, a full bleed image there. Now I'm going to go ahead and crop that photo. There that is. Let's go ahead and increase the transparency on the picture just a little bit. Let's go ahead up to maybe 30, let's go up to 40% there. That looks pretty nice. All right, now what we're gonna do is we are going to insert a text box. So let's go ahead and insert that text box. I'm going to make this a nice big bold chunky font in Aptos Black, and we're gonna go ahead and type Ruth Mango. That is her name. She's such a cute little cat. And we're going to go ahead, I'm going to center this text, and we're just going to increase the size nice and big. Now the spacing, the line spacing is just a little bit wide. So I want to go to the paragraph styles menu right here. I'm going to click on line spacing multiple, and let's go ahead and do 0.07 and see what that looks like. Ooh, that was really, really squished. Didn't mean to do that. 0.7 maybe. And that looks just a little bit better. Let's do it up. Let's click it up one more notch, and I'm going to go ahead and just drag that over there. Let's use our alignment tools to align this to the center. And I want this to be down just a little bit. Let's go ahead and turn this font white. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this. Control D to duplicate that text box. We're going to put it right on top of the other one. And then under the shape format tab, we're going to go to the text options right here. And I'm going to say the text fill, we're going to say no fill. And for the text outline, we're going to say white. So we're going to do that. And then I'm also going to increase the line weight on the white. So let's go all the way up to 3. That looks perfect. Now, I already had this photo. This is a photo of my cat, Ruth, that I had removed the background on. So I'm just gonna go ahead and copy that, and we will paste it over here on my slide. There's lots of other videos on this channel about how to remove backgrounds from your photo. You can just go up to that picture format tab in any photo, click on the remove background button right here, and work on removing the background of any photo that you have. You can get that photo focal image really nice and clear. Another way I like to do it is go and import that photo over into Canva, and Canva has a great background remover over there too, and then you can export that without the background. Okay. Now we know PowerPoint works in layers, so right now Ruth is on the top layer. I'm just going to go ahead and send her one layer back, so send to backward. That will give her one layer, and now you can see that we have that first text box on the top, the Ruth image right in the second layer, and on the third layer is the full white text right there. Now, if I wanted to apply a little bit of morph animation to this, let's go ahead and duplicate this slide. And now on the first slide, I'm gonna go ahead and just, with my down arrow key, I'm gonna put her all the way off the slide. And on this number four slide right here, we're gonna go ahead and apply the morph transition. And then you get a little preview, and that's what it's going to look like. Now, and you can see in my older version that the text actually decreased and increased just a little bit. And you can see now Ruth is different because because we moved her position on that first slide. So what we could actually do if we wanted to do something else is take Ruth over here, where she is. She's all the way down here. Let's bring her from the left to the right. And on this slide, I'm just gonna take her over here. And now watch, if we do preview, she'll just go right across the screen and fly right across the screen. Pretty cool. So if you wanted to make that text effect, all we would have to do here is let's go ahead and select these two text boxes, and then let's go ahead and decrease the font just a little bit right there. Okay, now in this morph preview, we can go ahead and put this in slideshow mode, and we'll see what it looks like. There's a small text Ruth Mango, And there we go, the text increases. So a really fun little effect there. I think you'll like it. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Sometimes really just for fun tricks just like this. I hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.